Okay, let's go back to the tape and see what other kind of cases we've got on here.
Kristen McKenzie. Come on in, have a seat. My name's Nikki, I'm one of the nurses. I need to ask you a few questions about what brought you here to the emergency department today. I also need to put this on your finger, and we'll take your temperature and your blood pressure.
Okay.
All right. So what brought you here today?
We're here in Boston on vacation. My daughter has a history of asthma. It's not bad, but she needs to use an inhaler when she plays sports. We're heading up north to go skiing, and she forgot her inhaler. I told her to pack it, even put it on the bed next to her suitcase, but she forgot.
Okay, so you're here for a prescription refill?
Yes.
All right. Kristen, how are you feeling? Any shortness of breath? You feel like you're wheezing at all?
No.
Okay, good.
A healthy 10-year-old with a history of asthma presents to the emergency department with her mother requesting a prescription for an inhaler. This child meets ESI level 5 criteria. She needs to be seen by a physician, have a prescription written, and be discharged by the nurse. If she had been wheezing a little, she would need a handheld nebulizer treatment with a pre and post peak flow, one resource, making her an ESI level 4. A level 3 asthmatic would be one who required a chest x-ray or labs, additional resources. If this patient was wheezing significantly and in severe distress with a good oxygen saturation, she would be ESI level 2. However, if she was decompensating, tiring, and had an SpO2 less than 90%, and the triage nurse was concerned she would require immediate intervention, she would meet ESI level 1 criteria.
So what do you think about that case? Pretty straightforward. What do you think? Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Okay.
I think the patient looks good. I know we get a lot of patients in the ED that come in because either they ran out of medication or they didn't have it. A lot of times we do see that, and I do agree that this case would be a level 5.
You know, I bet there's probably some nurses out there and some of us that want to kind of read more into the case. But she doesn't have any shortness of breath. She has absolutely no complaints. Another kind of example of the same thing is patients that come in with a different complaint and have a blood pressure that's up. Totally unrelated. So don't make things more than they are. She just wants a prescription refill. That's a 5.
Well, if I was triaging her, she told me she felt fine still. But I would still grab my stethoscope and still listen to her just, you know, in case, because of her history for asthma and because she's in a new area where the altitude or the weather is different. So I'd still be, you know, a little cautious about that.
That's another great point. You know, can you think of any other patients who would be ESI level 5?
Well, what about suture removal? That seems very simple. Is that a procedure, removing sutures?
No, we don't count that as a resource.
Oh, okay.
That would be an ESA level 5. Definitely. And you were saying?
I was going to say a rash as an example.
Yes. Many of those patients come in, you know, they just want to know what it is. They get a medical exam, and they're perhaps given PO medication and then discharged. Many of the time, you know, often it's discharge instructions. That's really what they need.
What else? A couple more.
What about, like, an adult that comes in with, like, a common cold because they couldn't sleep in the middle of the night? They're tossing and turning. They have no place else to, you know, they're not going to sleep, so they're going to come in.
Yeah, sure. As long as you don't think they're going to need a lab. If they're going to send a culture or throw culture, then they'd be one resource in level 4. There's a couple more 5s that are pretty common. Anything else?
Earaches in children.
That's a good one.
That looks stable.
A wound check.
Wound check is a great one. They come in all the time. Doesn't require any resources, just a physical exam.
Abrasion to the skin.
That's a very good example.
Yeah, that's
like a
really
small
good.
Abrasion. Mm-hmm.
Or a minor cut that turns out not to need suturing.
Another good one. You know, as I watched the scenario, I felt bad for the mother. You know, here she is on vacation and has to bring her child to the emergency department for a prescription refill. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes nurses in the ED really, you know, why are you here? They question that. And, you know, Paula, I think we both agree that, you know, there's nothing we can do about it. These patients, we want to see them, and we want to try and streamline them through the department.
And I think it's nice to see a patient where we can offer preventative care for a change. And also, like you said, someone from out of town that's stressed, you know, any patient that comes in, we should look at as an opportunity for customer service.
Good point.
And I felt kind of sorry for the little girl because I think she's going to hear about this a lot for her vacation, even though it was her fault.
Good point.